We were privileged from Lagos State University to attend the Art Fest in Catania July last year. And that has brought a lot of transformation to our research. The Catania had a special focus, the Art Fest. The focus was to train participants on technologies, which co-op to bring web, to use web as a service. So to bring your tools to the web or take the web to your tools so that people can use it. So it was all about open science. So we were exposed to a lot of, tools, which could be used to do, to achieve, open science. And so from there, the idea of MIPAR came. Is an idea I've been nursing for some time, but because I'm not an expert in this area of research, so I had no clue as how to actually go about this. But with the ACFest in Catania, I was able to start the development of MIPAR. And here are some use cases that we actually took to Catania in July last year. So there are use cases actually outside Africa, some from European countries. But from Africa, we had about 9 use cases across all the 4 countries, about 5 from Tanzania, and the rest distributed between Nigeria, Kenya, and South Africa. The ACFest was a huge success, and that motivated the ACFest in Lagos. That was November last year. This is just one slide on the ACFest in Lagos. So it was like replicating the ACFest in Catania. But it gave us the opportunity to bring many universities within Nigeria and even outside Nigeria. There was an education network from Ethiopia. Yes. So that joined. So well, in total, we had about 10 use cases, and MIPAR was one of them. The development of MIPAR started in Catania, but we continued during the ACFest in Lagos. Now, talking about medical image processor and repository, which we call MIPAR. So I just give some background. Medical images are images acquired from humans, and they are used for diagnosis, for treatment, and for patient management. But there are different ways of acquiring images. Some of these we are familiar with. X-ray is an example. Ultrasound is an example. MRI is an example. So, but each of these are specific, to the anatomy you want to look at, and they do have strengths depending on the tissue you are trying to image. But the field of medical image analysis and computer vision provides a platform to develop computational techniques for converting raw images to meaningful information. And you could take this further, actually, after the processing, and you look at analyzing the images using statistics. Then you can bring actually sense. You can make sense from your data. So we had a scientific problem we were trying to solve by developing MIPAR. There are about 4 major problems or limitations in medical image analysis. One is that the equipments are very, very expensive. For example, an MRI scanner costs about £1 million. And so that's really very expensive, as you will agree with me. And that will lean directly on that is the image acquisition. So if the machine is expensive, of course, patients have to pay for it. So it's very expensive to actually do image acquisition. And not only on the side of, the equipments, but the experts are even very rare. For example, if you want to use MRI scanner, you need a physicist who is an expert in pulse sequence development, and they are not very common in this part of the world. There are limited availability of experts, as mentioned, in Africa, and there's limited collaboration, And as Dr. Faye mentioned, it's not that we are not working hard in Africa, but we have this problem that we do not understand team spirit. Everybody wants to be the leader, so you want to do your own in your closed circuit, and I'm doing my own, rather than crossbreed and bring ideas together and manifesting, team spirit. Everybody is working individually, and that's not giving us the desired result. So the advancements in internet technology, data communication, and reduction in hardware has actually brought about the Science Gateway. And with the help of Science Gateway, it is possible to create image repository, as we're going to see in MIPAR, and it's possible to actually, you know, develop a graphical user interface, you know, and have it as a front end to a processing engine where somebody can actually assess the power of machines, you know, and it's possible to develop workflow, and it's quite possible with Science Gateway to make existing tools clever, by which I mean you can actually use them to interpret your data or bring sense or make sense out of your data. So Science Gateway is on top gear, to the best of my understanding, in Europe. But in Africa, the speed is not encouraging. For example, we know quite sure, to the best of our understanding, that there is no platform for medical image analysis in Africa. So we were motivated by all this, and then we came about developing MIPAR. So what is MIPAR? The name suggests, actually the meaning is medical image processor and repository. So it does two things, in one. So one is it allows you to share data. Sharing in this sense means you can donate your data and you can get data for free. Donation is free and getting or downloading data is free. So we're using open science technology. And as Roberto said, it's not just making things available online that makes them open, but there are licenses that comes with this. So MIPAR is a typical example of a new infrastructure which supports open science. So this is the URL, and MIPAR is one of the products of collaboration between Lagos State University, LASU, and Sci-GaIA. So I want to say, actually, we are seriously from Lagos State University blessed by meeting the Sci-GaIA team. So when can I use MIPAR? You need MIPAR if you answer yes to any of these. Do you need medical images for your research? We have statisticians, we have computer scientists, mathematicians. You want to develop models, and the models need medical image and data. So MIPAR is a place you have to visit. And do you have medical images to share? You want to give it out for free? Then you consider using MIPAR. You have a case study to share, or you need an expert to process your medical images. As I said before, medical image analysts are very rare, and so you can just upload your images and get it, processed without any problem. And MIPAR is free. And in case you have any interest in collaborating with us, you have data you want to donate, that's my email address. Now, I talk about the system analysis and design. So this just gives us a summary of what MIPAR does. So using a use case diagram. So you can donate images, you can process images, you can download outputs of processed images, and then you can actually download images for free, and you can analyze your images. Now, here I have different types of images. We have not included all of them in MIPAR, but our target is that CT scan could be available, MRI, data, Doppler, ultrasound, and different anatomy, brain, liver, lung, and chest. And these are sample imaging format. So HDR, IMG pair, and Nifty and Nifty GZ. At the current time, we use ZIP. So though we allow HDR, IMG, and Nifty, but you have to ZIP your images before you submit to MIPAR. Now, some of the processes that we can do on MIPAR, at the current time, we have only implemented MIPAR for MRI and brain, MRI brain. So other anatomies we have not included. But in the context of MRI, brain images, there are processes like brain extraction, image segmentation, and image registration. All these are fully implemented in MIPAR at the current time. So system requirements. The first one is for software developers, but as an end user, what do you need to use MIPAR? All you need is you have a web browser. Of course, you need internet, and you have an operating system. So you have access to internet data, and you just connect to MIPAR, and there you go. You can use it without any problem. Hardware requirement, a fairly decent computer. So nothing of high spec, because all the processing are done at the back end. So the modules of MIPAR. So there are five of them, actually. So starting with registration, and you can donate images, download them, or download images donated by others, process images, or analyze. But for registration, you need a federated identity. And so it's not registering only for MIPAR. But once you have the federated identity, then you can use MIPAR. So, but I will still show some slides about federation identity. So this is the home page of MIPAR. So we have the home page about us, login, how you can log in, FAQ. So all these are available. And so we provided some information, just giving you background of what MIPAR can do. Now, to access or to use MIPAR, as I said previously, you need federated identity, and this is free. So you just look through any of these, any of them that seems to be, relevant to you, you can register, and then you have the login details. And once you have that, you can use MIPAR and other tools that are associated with this. So just assuming that you are registering, if you look through this and none seems to be what you are familiar with, you are allowed to use casual, or GIDP. And so you can log in without any problem, even when you are not directly affiliated with an institution. Now, this is the image donation model. So what can you do here? So with MIPAR, if you want to donate an image, you have to click, the donate image menu, and that gives you the option to select the type of image you want to donate, the anatomy. And once that is done, and you just click the donate button, then the image is submitted. And you can see the progress bar showing you, how the upload is going. So we use OAR, Open Access Repository, a product of Sci-GaIA. So when images are donated, it actually goes to OAR and it is kept there. So you can search and find it, but we have our interface which masks the OAR. So you won't see OAR actually, but you see MIPAR. Now you can search and download. So even if you do not necessarily have to donate before you can download, as long as you have federated identity. So in case you want to download, it's very similar to uploading. So you can search for the images you want to download. And so the type of image and the anatomy, you select them. And then this queries OAR database and fetches anything that is related to what you actually want to download. So after downloading, it is possible that you want to visualize. For brain MRI, there are special tools for visualization. One of them is called MRI Crow. So I will show us an image, a brain image, in a minute. But this is just a screen to show us, the output of the search. So you have chosen the type of image, and the anatomy. And after submitting the query, this is what came out as an image that meets your search criteria. And so once you see this, you just click on that, and then it's downloaded. The images are downloaded to your local machine. Now, this is to visualize. So this is MRI Crow. It's a software for visualizing MRI images. So this simply shows us a brain image. So we call this anatomical image, a T1 weighted image, and it's a structural scan, meaning it allows you to see the different structure in the brain. And it's a very clean image, 1 millimeter resolution. So we show the 3D, the corona, sagittal, and the axial view. So just to give us an idea of how a brain MRI looks like. Now, we have talked about donating images, downloading images. Now you want to process your image. So before you process any image, you need to understand what kind of processes you want to actually do. So we assume here that the target is to do brain extraction. Brain extraction in MRI brain imaging simply means you remove non-brain tissue. So you remove the skull and the scalp. So what it remains will just be the tissue, the raw brain, And so with this, it is possible to
remove non-brain tissue. So we call it brain extraction. So once you select the type of process, and you, of course, you have to upload your image anyway. So you have a set of images you want to brain extract. So you select the brain extraction, option, and then you upload your images and you click the process button. And then that is done. But this is after you have done the processing, you want to see the output. So you can click on the process the images, menu, and that gives you all the data or the output of everything you have processed. And it shows you the status. Actually, if you submit a set of images and it's not processed, you will see under the status that it was not processed. So you will know and you can work out what the problem could be. But in this case, what we have is that all the images are, successfully processed. One is brain extracted, the other one, brain segmentation has been done, and then we have the third one. So we see this, and once you get the output, you can just download to your local machine. So this is to show us an output of brain extraction. So what you observe here is that the non-brain tissue has been removed. The skull is gone. And so we didn't develop the tool for doing brain extraction because the tool is available, developed by Oxford University, called FSL. So what we had to put it at the back end and then wrote some codes to make it available on MIPAR. Though this segmentation is not clean, this brain extraction, because the eyes is still there, and normally we want to get rid of the eyes when we are processing brain images. So now we talk about the analyze module. So if once in medical image analysis, you process your images, yes, so we can see the output of a processed image is another image. But what you really want to do is to get information from your image, and that is why we need statistics. So, but previously in Catania, we could not really figure out how to introduce the analyze module. But in Lagos, we did that. So that was our major achievement in Lagos. So from in MIPAR now, it is possible for you to analyze your images and to analyze set of data. So they are simple analysis though, but these are things that could help you to make sense from your images. So you can do simple regression, correlation. You can have two sets of brain, MRI brain images acquired, maybe from those who have traumatic brain injury and those who are the control, normal control. And you can compare them with MIPAR, and it can tell you if there are changes, significant changes between those two sets. You can do correlation, and then we can do, within group comparison or within measurement comparison. So trying to wrap up now, what are our future plans? So MIPAR is fully implemented and is available freely. But at the current time, we are seeking funds to publicize MIPAR and to get data into MIPAR. So we only have some sample data. And what one of our targets is that data is available for everybody to use. So we now need to talk to institutions or organizations that have data that could go on MIPAR, and then we can include that. But we need some funds to do that. MIPAR was tested with brain MRI, as I previously said. So we only implemented on brain MRI. Now is the time for us to include other imaging modality. So currently, one of my PhD students will be focusing on this, so that, and there are a couple of MSc students too who will be studying how to process other types of imaging that are not from MRI, CT, and others. And we want to include other anatomy. So what we have currently is only on brain, but we want to see lung, we want to see liver, we want to see every other anatomy. In conclusion, Catania Hackfest was very, very successful, and it gave us the opportunity to learn about open science and the science gateway, and gave birth to MIPAR, and gave birth, of course, to Lagos Hackfest, which was hugely productive as well. So with MIPAR, in summary, you can share, process, and analyze medical images. So I just want to thank all the co-founders of Sci-GaIA, and then all those who funded the Hackfest as well, and those who give us the information about the advert, the call for Hackfest, that's Echo Connect and Wacron, and the team that has been working behind the scene. So appreciation to everybody. And of course, thank you for listening.